ओम नमः प्रणवार्ताय शुद्धज्ञानैकमूर्तये निर्मलाय प्रशांताय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। यन्नित्यमानन्दमनन्तमेकं शिवेति नाम्ना श्रुतयो गृणन्ति तस्यावतारो नररूपधारी कृपासुदाब्धी भुवि रामकृष्णः। जननीं शारदां देवीं रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयोः श्रुत्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। यैरिमे गुरुभिः पूर्वं पदवाक्यप्रमाणतः व्याख्याता सर्ववेदान्ताः तान्नित्यं प्रणतोऽस्म्यहम्। यस्यात्मभूतस्य गुरोः प्रसादात् अहं विमुक्तोऽस्मि शरीरबन्धात्। सर्वोपदेष्टुः पुरुषोत्तमस्य तस्याङ्घ्रियुग्मं प्रणतोऽस्मि नित्यम्।
एव्री इंडिविजुअल who believes in the existence of God, who believes in the validity of religious life, has a basic question: what is the final achievement of my religious life? If you ask this question to Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, he says the final achievement of not only religious life, the final achievement of very human life is attaining God. Then we ask the question, what do you mean by attaining God? Various type of answers come. Attaining God means realizing the God, having spiritual enlightenment. What will happen if I realize God, if I have spiritual enlightenment? Then the answer is given, you will get moksha. By attaining God, you get moksha. That is the answer we get in the various religious books and scriptures. Then we asked a question, what do you mean by moksha? If moksha is meant that I will get 1,000 lashes daily having attained God, I will get moksha. If moksha is equal to painful and getting beaten, then I don't want that moksha. So the question comes, what do you mean by moksha? If anyone is fortunate, he will go to the Guru Parampara and ask this question. Unfortunate people go to bookstall and purchase some book and read. When you go to Guru Parampara, especially Vedanta Guru Parampara, it says moksha means Brahma Bhavaha, being Brahman. Nothing lesser than that. Then, what do you mean by Brahman? Where is he? Answer is given, Tadu Jagat Karanam Brahma Tvamasi. It is you, therefore moksha need not be attained. You see the answer? What is the first question? How to attain God? Or how to attain moksha. Then Vedanta Guru Parampara says, moksha need not be attained. Why? Sarupatva, it is you yourself. And not only need not be attained, cannot be attained. Because it is nityam. It is eternal. You want moksha to be eternal, therefore it should be nityam. Being nityam, it cannot be attained. because anything attained is anitya. Therefore, one should struggle to discover this fact instead of attaining moksha. What is the fact? That I am nitya muktaha is the satyam, because this fact is revealed by antima pramanam called Vedanta pramana. Nobody can refute it. Therefore, mokshaha means gaining atmajnanam or discovering our own infinite nature, because samsaraha is a notional problem. Being separated from God, being separated from the ananda vastu is nothing but atasmin tad buddhihi adhyasaha. It is a notional problem. For any notional problem, the solution is knowledge. From where you get all these informations? From Vedanta only we get all these informations. Ashariragam shareeshu anavaste shvavasthitam mahantam vibhumatmanam matva dhiraha na shochati. Dhiraha na shochati. A atmajnani doesn't suffer. What type of atmajnani? We are all atmajnanis only. Atma means I. We know about ourselves. We have our own bio data, which gives bhayam to others. Therefore, it is called bio data. We are all atmajnani, not that type of atmajnanam. Mahantam vibhum atmam matva dhiraha na shochati. Who is that mahantam vibhum atmanam? Where is he? Where is he? Ashariragam shareeshu. He doesn't have sharira, but he is manifested in sharira. He is not sharira. He doesn't have sharira, but he manifests in all sharira. Anavasteshu avasthitam mahantam vibhum atmanam matva dhiraha na shochati. Therefore, you need not attain mokshaha. It is your very nature. No, I don't like this definition at all. Then Vedanta says, no other definition is possible for the word called mokshaha. No other definition is valid for the word called mokshaha. Other definitions don't have either Shastra Pramanam or Anumana Pramanam, logic, or Pratyaksha Pramanam. In the beginning of this series of class, we saw that having gone to some other place also, the person is subject to suffering. For example, Jaya and Vijaya, okay? So they were with the Lord himself, but because they were not having this knowledge of identity with the Lord, they have to come back. So Shastra doesn't support any other definition of moksha. And Nyaya also doesn't support. We saw that in the first class. And Pratyaksham also doesn't support. Therefore, no other possibility of gaining freedom from the suffering of human life. If at all one is serious enough, that person should divert all his sadhana to gain this knowledge, not to gain the Lord, not to gain mokshaha. Because mokshaha is nityavastu, our own swarupam. Lord is sarvagataha, he is available already with us. We are separated from the Lord, we are separated from the infinite nature of ourselves just by sheer confusion. Therefore, one should struggle to gain the knowledge or qualification for gaining the knowledge, either for jnanam or for jnana yogyata. Nitya mokshaha always is in the form of sarvoham. Aham ब्रह्मास्मि. दैट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ नित्य मोक्षः विदाउट आत्मज्ञानम. अहम् ब्रह्मास्मि इति ज्ञानम्. विदाउट दिस ज्ञानम् मोक्ष इज नेवर पॉसिबल वेर एवर यू गो. वेदांत सेज इवन इफ यू फोल्ड द आकाश लाइक बेड यू विल नॉट गेन मोक्ष विदाउट आत्मज्ञानम. कैन एनीबडी फोल्ड द आकाश लाइक बेड. यथा चर्मवदाकाशं वेष्टयिष्यन्ति मानवाः तदा देवं अविज्ञाय दुःखस्यान्ते भविष्यति. दुःखस्य अन्तः भविष्यति. एवरीबडी वांट्स आई वांट टू एंड ऑल माय सफरिंग. व्हेन इट इज अटेन्ड देवं विज्ञाय. इफ एनीबडी सेज नो आई डोंट वांट आत्मज्ञानम इट्स ऑल ड्राई फिलोसॉफिकल देन वेदांत सेज देवम अविज्ञाय दुःखस्य अन्तः न भविष्यति. इट इज इम्पॉसिबल. लाइक चर्मवत आकाशम वेष्टयिष्यन्ति मानवाः. कैन एनीबडी फोल्ड दि आकाश लाइक चर्म. चर्म मीन स्किन. इफ यू से नो आई विल गेट इट आफ्टर गोइंग टू वैकुंठ आर शिवलोक. वेदांत सेज तद यथा इह कर्मचितो लोकः क्षीयते एवमेव अमुत्रः पुण्यजितो लोकः क्षीयते. वेर एवर यू गो एनी टाइप ऑफ पुण्य लोक यू गो अप टू वैकुंठ शिवलोक आर ब्रह्मलोक. लाइक लाइफ इज मिसरबल एंड सब्जेक्ट टू अराइवल एंड डिपार्चर सिमिलरली देर आल्सो विल बी लाइफ विल बी मिसरबल एंड सब्जेक्ट टू अराइवल एंड डिपार्चर. देयरफॉर व्हाट इज द वे न कर्मणा न प्रजया धनेन त्यागे नैके अमृतत्व मानशुहु. By giving up our own false notions, by giving up our own judgment that I am small and insignificant, by giving up jivatva, by giving up parichinnatvam about ourselves, we gain the ultimate result of our religious life. Yada he vaisha etasmin udaramantaram kurute atatasya bhayam bhavati. Even an iota of difference between you and the Lord exists. Atha tasya bhayam bhavati. Bhishasmat vatav pavate. Bhishodeti suryaha. Bhishad agnishchendrascha. Mrityuhu davati panchamayiti. If devatas have ignorance, if devatas don't have knowledge about the identity of the individual and the infinite nature of the individual, they also are subject to bhayam. Therefore son veshtavyah tad vijignasitavyah. Yaha atma apahata papma vijaraha vimrutyuh vishokaha vijigatsaha apipasaha satyakamaha satyasankalpah saha anveshtavyah saha vijignasitavyah. Therefore one should struggle in knowing that atma which happened to be apahata papma, sinless one, vijaraha, no jara, no old age at all, vimrutyuh, no death at all, apipasaha, no hunger and thirst at all, satya sankalpaha, satya kamaha. Who can be satya sankalpaha and satya kamaha? Only Ishvara can be satya sankalpaha and satya kamaha. That Ishvara happened to be atma iti anveshtavyaha vijignasitavyaha atmava are drashtavyaha. Therefore one should struggle in human life. Otherwise life is a sheer waste. योवा एतदक्षरं गार्गी अविदित्वा अस्मा लोकात् प्रैति सः कृपणः. अथ यः एतदक्षरं गार्गी विदित्वा अस्मा लोकात् प्रैति सः ब्राह्मणः. सो ही इज ए रिचर्ड पर्सन, मिसरेबल वन, अनफॉर्चुनेट वन, बिकॉज वेर एवर ही गोस ही कैनॉट फाइंड हिम. How? Because he happens to be himself. Suppose somebody goes on searching for himself and ask everyone, have you seen me? Have you seen me? Have you seen me? Can anybody answer for this question? Suppose a person goes on asking everyone, sir, have you seen me? Sir, have you seen me? Can anyone get it? Therefore, Shastra says, Viditva asma lokat praiti saha brahmanaha. He is an intelligent one who knows this secret about himself. Otherwise, brahmatam paradat yo anyatra atmanaha brahmaveda, kshatram tam paradat yo anyatra atmanaha kshatram veda, sarvam tam paradat yo anyatra atmanaha sarvam veda. Everything which you consider as different from you will be rejected by that entity. You will have suffering from that entity. Because idam brahma, idam kshatram, ime loka, ime deva, imani bhutani, idagum sarvam, yadayam atma. When you reject yourself, you are rejected by yourself. When you reject yourself, you are rejected by yourself. When you reject the treasure which is already with you become a poor person. Correct? When you reject the treasure already which is within you, you become a beggar. That is why human life is full of begging. Do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? That's why if anybody says, I love you, we want to know the reason for it. Why you love me? Why you love me? Because I know nobody can love me. Why you love me? So that person has to find out some answer. Your eyes are nice, your nose are nice, your ears are nice, something. He has to find out some answer. Therefore, if a person is intelligent enough, entire religious and spiritual life should be either for Atma Jnanam or for gaining qualification for Atma Jnanam, either for Jnanam or Jnana Yogyata. And this Jnanam is gained either in this Loka or some other Loka. This Mokshaha is gained here or some other life. That's all. Difference is that's all. If it is gained here, it is called Sadhyo Muktihi. It is called Sadhyo Muktihi. Gaining knowledge about one's own infinite nature is called Sadhyo Muktihi. If it is not gained here, then naturally the person being religious and tapasvi and devoted to the Lord, naturally he will go to higher lokas. There Brahmaji will teach. There Vishnu will teach. There Shiva will teach. There also. Because unless you know this fact, you will be troublesome person there. As long as you are a small entity having a begging bowl, oh Lord, give me, give me, give me, give me. Here, the begging bowl was expected to be filled with artha, kama and dharma. Give me money, give me wealth, give me children, like that here. We want to fill the begging bowl. After going there, what we will ask? We will not ask certainly give me wealth or give me putra, but we will ask what? Give me kainkarya lakshmihi. That also wealth. I want to serve you, Lord. I want to serve you, O Lord. So you will be troublesome person there. Bhagavan has to give you this knowledge. And he will see that because you are a great devotee who wanted to serve the Lord, who is dedicated completely his life for the sake of Lord. So Bhagavan will give that knowledge. If that knowledge is given there, it is called Krama Mukti. Gradual Moksha. Krama Mukti means what? Gradual Moksha. Having gone to higher lokas, if the knowledge is gained, it is called Krama Muktihi. Having gone there, you will have result of your own tapasya, your own meditation. What is the result of tapasya and meditation? We saw that. Salokya, samipya, sarupya, sarshti, sayujyadi. Either you will be the citizen of the higher loka, or you will be near the Lord, or you will be appearing as Lord appears, and you will be allowed to serve the Lord. It's all depend upon your karma phalam, which are in the form of your tapasya and your meditation. But having gone there also, if you don't gain this, then again what? Kshine punye martya lokam vishanti. Tetam bhuktva swarga lokam vishalam. Kshine punye martya lokam vishanti. A brahma bhuvana loka punaravartino arjuna. Anywhere you go, you have to come back. Come back means what? Come back to not particular place. Come back to the self-knowledge. Therefore, if you are intelligent enough, here itself you will gain it. Because going there is problematic. Shukla Marga, they call it. First condition to go there is successfully you should die. What do you mean by successful death? What do you mean by successful death? The meaning of successful death is you should not be admitted in ICU ward. Can you give guarantee? You should not have coma state while dying. Can you give guarantee? You should have the remembrance of the Lord, and you should be in a state of mind where you have to utter the name of the Lord. Om. And meditating the Lord, you have to give up your body. Having noted down the day and timing, can anybody say that? Are we in that condition? Can we claim, I can manage to be without coma, without being admitted in IC unit, and with full consciousness, and I will remember the Lord? Prana prayana samaye kapavata pittaihi kantavarodhana vidau smaranam kutaste. Who sings this? Great saint, our Kulasekhara Alvar. If Kulasekhara Alvar sings like that, another Alvar says, appodekke ippode solli vaithe. I don't know where will be my death. So while living, while our body is healthy, our mind is in a manageable condition, we should make strong suggestion. We should give this one goal as the goal of all our spiritual practices. So either you gain knowledge here, or having gone there, you gain knowledge there. If you gain knowledge here, it is called sadhyo muktihi. Having gained that knowledge, still that person continues to live in this body as a jivan muktaha. As a jivan muktaha, he continues to live in this body, and his body and mind becomes instrument in the hands of the totality, the Lord. Loka sankrahartam, it is used by the Lord. They are called acharyas. Somebody must be there to give the knowledge to the next generation. Correct? Who will give the knowledge? Can ignorant person give knowledge? Only a knowledgeable person can give knowledge. If knowledgeable person dies immediately after gaining knowledge, who will teach the world? Therefore, there is a mechanism in this infrastructure called a creation, that Guru Parampara. In that Guru Parampara, only rishis, mahatmas are continue to live, and in spite of their physical suffering, they don't have any suffering. That is a peculiarity of jivan muktihi. Jivaha jivan api muktaha. It is like a dagda bhijavate. Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna used to say, it is like a burnt seed or a burnt rope. Both will not have any transaction afterwards. Burnt seed will not sprout. Burnt rope will not be helpful to tie anything. So no bandaha. Kimichan kasya kamaya shariram anusanjare. Desiring what for whose sake? he is going to run towards sense pleasures. Apuryamanam achala pratishtam samudramapa pravishanti yadvate. Like that, his life is full of happiness. In Vedanta, in one Upanishad, the happiness of a jnani is nicely imitated.
Ahamannam, 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 ahamannado, ahamannado, ahamannadaha, ahag shloka krit, ahag shloka krit, ahag shloka krit, ahamasmi prathamajasya.
Like that, entire life is a beautiful singing. That's why Bhagavan Krishna also says, ihaiva tairjita sargaha yesham samye manasthitaha. One whose mind is established in samavastu. What is that samavastu? Sarvagata vastu alone can be samavastu. That sarvagata vastu is one's own real nature. Whose mind is established in one's own real nature is jitaha. He has conquered this creation. Where? Ihaiva. Here and now itself. What will be the benefit of this knowledge? Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane gavihastini shunichaiva shopakecha pandita samadarshinaha. His entire life is a blessing to the society because of his mere existence. He need not even preach also. Just sheer existence gives the blessings to the humanity. And fortunately, till date, we have people who have this knowledge, whose existence is a blessing to the society. Therefore, one should gain this knowledge, one should at least try to gain this knowledge in this Janma itself. If you miss the bus, better luck next bus. And if you gain through the next bus called a Krama Mukti. This Krama is gradual. The Krama means what? Gradual. From which standpoint it is gradual? From the standpoint of the human body it is gradual. Correct? But there it is again Sadhyo Mukti. From the standpoint of divine body, you gain Sadhyo Mukti only. So whether it is Krama Mukti or Sadhyo Mukti, whether it is here or after going to some other loka, one should gain this knowledge because it is our right. And that is the reason entire infrastructure called this creation is given. If anybody asks why this creation, just to gain this knowledge. What is the purpose of this entire creation infrastructure? Just to give a chance for every individual to know his own infinite nature. Why this Guru Parampara? Same answer. Why spiritual practices? Same answer. Why should I be dharmic? Same answer. Why should I worship God? Same answer. That's what Bhagavan says in Gita. Sarvam karmakhilam partha jnane parisamapyate. All types of activities have validity in this knowledge. Whose activity? Whether it is individual's activity or Ishwara's activity. You imagine Ishwara goes on creating the creation, but nobody wants to worship him. Will he not be unhappy? It is like building a big 5-star hotel, nobody comes and use it. Naturally, the owner will be disappointed. All cannot come to 5-star hotel. Similarly, all will not gain in this Janma itself. But the purpose of this entire infrastructure is what? Gaining Atma Jnana. This is the assertion of entire Vedantic scripture. Bhagavan Shankaracharya, in his Brahma Sutra Bhashya, he says, Aham Brahmasmi iti etat avasana eva sarve vidhayaha sarvani cha itarani pramanani. The validity of all Shastra Pramanas, all other Pramanas is up to gaining this knowledge. Aham Brahmasmi iti etat avasana eva sarve vidayaha, all types of Vedic vidis, injunctions, satyam vada dharmam chara, you should be a devotee of the Lord, you should follow dharma, you should be a gentleman, all these vidis, whether it is given by the society or by the shastram or by the doctor, All prescriptions are up to which time it is valid? Up to the time of gaining this knowledge. Therefore, one should be very, very shrewd enough, intelligent enough in gaining this knowledge, because just by sheer gaining, we become that entity. Brahma vite Brahma eva bhavati. All idea about our papa karma, punarjanma, suffering, everything goes away. Kshiyante chasya karmani tasmin drishte paravare. Only negative things go away? No, you gain positive thing. What is that? Anandam brahmano vidwan na bhibeti kutashchaneti. You will not have fear for any blessed thing in this world. That's why when a shishya gained the knowledge, the teacher says, abhayam vai janaka praptosi. Hey janaka, hey shishya. Shishya was Janaka Maharaja. Hey shishya, you have attained abhayam. How you attained abhayam? Tad atmanam eva avet aham brahmasmi iti tasmat tat sarvam abhavat. You have become everything. There is no second entity at all to create problem to you. There is no second entity at all in reality other than you. Therefore, tad sarvam abhavat. You have become everything. By what you have become everything? By bulging your body? No, by knowledge you became everything. How can you become everything by knowledge? Because you are everything already. Once you gain this knowledge, tatrako mohaha kashokaha ekatvam anupashyata. One who knows that spiritual identity with the entire creation, ko mohaha kashokaha. Therefore, one should be intelligent enough to gain this knowledge, at least try to gain this knowledge. Then we may have a question. Okay, what about other lokas, going to other lokas? Please tell. I am not sure whether I will gain this knowledge in this Janma at all. Now itself I have 50 years, 60 years, I am not sure. Arjuna also had this. All my spiritual practices will go waste. Bhagavan says, Nahi kalyana krit kachit durgatim tada gachati prapya punya kritan loka ushitva shashvati samaha shuchi nam srimatam gehe yoga brashtopi jayate. Prapya punya kritan loka. You will go to punya krita loka. There you may get citizenship or nearness with the Lord or appearance like Lord or you will be one with the Lord as Mala, or you may be the servant of the Lord. All possibilities are there. But if you stop with that end, then you are a loser. After gone there, you should again try to gain this knowledge. Wherever you go, Pona Mama, Thirimbi Varuvar. Then what about another question? What about having divine visions? Is not divine vision the end of spiritual life? Vedanta says no. Maximum you can say that your mind is pure and devoted. Unless you have this knowledge, however much you have divine vision, it is invalid. Your visions have validity only when you have self-knowledge. How can you say so, Swami? How can you say so? Simple logic. Have you seen God with your form? Yes. Then he is not God. Simple. Because definition of God is what? Chetana vastu. Seer is the God, not the seen object. Nedam editam upasate. Got the point? Nedam editam upasate. Tat kenakam pashyet, tat kenakam shunyat, vijnataram are, kena vijaniyat. Who can see the seer? Got the point? So, anything stands in front of you, different from you, is not original God. But many Mahatmas, Jnanis had visions. Yes, they had visions, but they had this knowledge also. Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna's life, if you see, he had visions. Every day in, day out, he had these visions. But they are all valid visions because it is backed by self-knowledge. They are all valid. Your visions have validity only when you have self-knowledge. If you don't have the self-knowledge, even if you see the Trimurtis in vision with your own eyes, your samsara will not go. Example, Ravana. Ravana saw all devatas, including Trimurtis. Brahmaji he has seen, Shiva he has seen, Vishnu also he has seen in the form of Rama. His samsara did not go. Therefore, the validity for divine vision is what? This knowledge. Do you want to have valid divine vision? Gain this knowledge. It can be supplementary. Without knowledge, this divine vision cannot guarantee freedom. All asuras had divine visions. Instead of getting away from the samsara, every asura asked boon which can perpetuate their samsara. Understand? Hiranyakashipu, Ravana, Kumbhakarna. Why divine vision? You live with God, with flesh and blood. You live with God. Still, it has no meaning unless you have this knowledge. With Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, many people lived. With Mother Sarada Devi, many people lived. But their samsara never gone. Not only it has not gone, in Ravana's case, it has increased. We are all trying to see the Divine Mother at least a moment in our life in divine vision. Correct? In Ravana's case, he saw the Divine Mother with flesh and blood. Instead of getting nivritti from samsara, he got pravritti in samsara. He got lustful ideas even after seeing Divine Mother. Therefore, knowledge is the only criterion. With knowledge, you have samadhi, you have divine visions, you live with the God, all are useful. Otherwise, they are not valid. Not valid in the sense, not valid in removing your samsara. You might have got it. Shastra never denies the possibility of getting divine vision. Shastra never denies the getting into nirvikalpa samadhi state. It says, all right, nice. But what is the use, you tell? If your samsara is going to increase by gaining all those things, what is the use of it? Therefore, being a mumukshuhu, being a jignasuhu, one should be very clear. Entire purpose of my spiritual life will be either purifying my mind or gaining this knowledge. If my mind is already pure enough, if mind is already qualified enough, with sadhana chaturshtaya sampatti, with viveka vairagya and shamadhi shatka sampatti and mumukshutvam, I will struggle to gain this knowledge. If I find that I lack all those things, I will concentrate in gaining those things, not in gaining visions. That's why in Sri Ramakrishna's life itself, we can see many people used to get visions. When Swami Vivekananda wanted to have one vision, so Sri Ramakrishna told, hey, it is not for you. It's all children's play. When Ramakrishna Anandaji Maharaj wanted to have a vision, then Sri Ramakrishna told, hey, if you also sit in samadhi and vision, who will serve me? Who will serve me? So they can be supplementary. But they don't guarantee the moksha. You don't need them. Like a person doesn't need a hat on his head. Okay? There is no need. It's all ornamental. Divine visions are ornamental. Mystical experiences are ornamental for jnanis and mahatmas. In Shankaracharya's life, we find lot of mystical experiences he had, and he is explaining those experiences in the form of stotras. When he went to Kashi, he had the vision of Shiva, he had the vision of Annapuranidhi. Immediately one stotra will come. In Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna's life itself, we can see every moment he goes anywhere, there according to that place and that tanmatras he gets. When he went to Kashi, he had the vision of Bhagavan Shiva. So they are possible, but whether they are useful for us or not is the question. Shastra says, if your mind is pure with vairagyam, or if your mind is with knowledge, they are all useful and valid. Otherwise, it is a waste and you don't need them. It's not an important thing. If it comes, it is nice. It is like getting rasagulla. Rasagulla cannot fill your stomach, you know. That annam will fill your stomach. Annam will remove your hunger. Rasagulla will not remove your hunger. So therefore, as bhaktas, as religious people, we should know what is the validity of every blessed thing in our spiritual life. Without purity, which is very, very necessary for gaining freedom, without that purity, any amount of visions will lead to more and more samsara. What about people who lived with Bhagavan? Those who have this knowledge and purity, they were nice with Bhagavan. Like Lakshmana and Hanumanji and Swami Vivekananda. Same Bhagavan. Without purity and knowledge, same Bhagavan is the source of sorrow for others, like Ravana and Hazra. Correct? So, one should be very, very clear. What about this mystical experience? They are valid, but they will be useful only if a person is pure and with knowledge. Then what about Nirvikalpaka Samadhi? Nirvikalpaka Samadhi talked in Vedanta is entirely different from the Nirvikalpaka Samadhi talked in Patanjali Yoga Sutram. In Patanjali Yoga Sutram, Nirvikalpaka Samadhi is a state of mind. And in that state of mind, the Patanjali Yogi gained something called knowledge, which he claims as knowledge, but it is not knowledge because Dvaitam is Satyam according to them. But Nirvikalpa Samadhi talked in Vedanta is not a state of mind. It is Jnana Nishta. Pashyan, Srinvan, Sprishan, Jihran, Ashnan, Gachan, Swapan, Swashan, Pralapan, Visrujan, Grinnan, Unmishan, Nimishan, Napi, Indriyani, Indriyarteshu Vartante, Naiva Kinjit Karomi. It is Jnana Nishta. It is knowledge. Nirvikalpa Samadhi talked in Vedanta Parampara is knowledge. In spite of doing all these physical and mental activities, naiva kinjit karomi. Gunaha guneshu vartante. So that is the difference one should know. It is called sahaja samadhi. In Vedantic language, it is called sahaja samadhi. The Vedanta jnani doesn't close his eyes and tries to get in a particular state of mind. Whether he is in battlefield or in market or in cave, he is the embodiment of happiness, embodiment of clarity. Anywhere you found Bhagavan Krishna was shutting himself in caves, always he is roaming. If no work in Dwaraka, he will go to Hastinapur, because a lot of work is there. And even at the most difficult times, he was embodiment of Ananda. Prahasanniva Bharata, in battlefield with Kauravas, when Arjuna is broken down, how he was? Prahasanniva Bharata. And when his own family people are fighting and dying, and Uddhava was seeing that fight and death and crying and complaining to the Lord that you are not saving them, he says, who are my relatives? Who are not my relatives? Uddhava, he asks the question. Therefore, this clarity, which is in the form of knowledge, is the last word in spiritual life. That should be very, very clear. In between the travel, you may get down at Nirvikalpa Samadhi, you may get down at visions, if you are fortunate to live with the Lord, because when Bhagavan is going to come with flesh and blood, we don't know. If you are fortunate, you may live with the God. But still what we have to do? Being intermediary sages, again we have to get inside the train and start the spiritual journey, which is going to end in the form of Atma Jnana. Okay, all our doubts, being devotees, all our doubts are clarified. What about Nastika's doubts? In the first class I dealt it. When the Shastra claimed that attaining God is the only fruitful thing in human life, the Nastika ridiculed us. Correct? Which God you want to attain, he asked. And he asked the question, is that God is with form or without form? If he is with form, then he cannot be God, because he will die. Because any form means qualities. What is the use of attaining God who is going to die? And if you say he is without form, then how can you say you are going to attain him? Because without form means he is always everywhere. Where is the question of attaining something which doesn't have form? So he ridiculed us. What is the answer you know? The God which Vedanta talks about, the God which has to be attained, is none other than you yourself. If you deny that God which is revealed by Vedanta, you are denying yourself. Asanneva sabhavati asat brahmeti vedachet. You become asat if you say Brahman is asat. You become asat if you say God is asat. You cannot say I am asat. Because to say, you should be sat. Understood? You may reject the God which is sitting somewhere else behind the clouds. You may reject the God who is considered or believed to be hiding somewhere else. But the God which Vedanta talks about, you can never deny, because it happens to be you yourself. No, I know myself, I attain myself. Where is the question of attaining me again? No, you have not attained yourself. No, I have attained myself. Okay, who are you? Our question, old question. Who are you? Who are you whom you have attained? You tell. You will tell what? His biodata will tell. I am so and so. That is your name. I am son of so and so. That is your father's name. I am engineer. That is your profession. Who are you? I am human being. That also only species. So you don't know. So attaining yourself through knowledge. Understand? So he asked the question, which God you want to attain? The answer is what? Atmanaha Brahmatvam. The infinite God who is in the form of I. Is he with form or without form? He doesn't have any form, but he can manifest as all forms. Then third question he asked, do you attain God while living or after death? In both ways I can do it. Because there is no death at all for me. So your question is illogical. There is a death for body. I don't die. Even as an ignorant person, I don't die. If you say you die, that means what? You consider yourself body only. If you consider yourself as very body, that means what? You are only fluids. I need not talk to fluids. Can anyone talk to fluids? If you say, I am body, you are a dead person. Ratta mamsa asti, and all types of unwanted, untouchable, filthy bag. So I need not talk to you. That's why in our Vedanta parampara, this Charuvaka philosophy was never discussed. But they are only they are only loudly speaking, you know. So therefore I am trying to tell them, they are nowhere near our clarity of thinking. These materialistic people, kavo pio, suffering karo people are there na, they are nowhere near us. We need not talk to them. You can say, all right, if you are happy with your filthy bag, dirghayushman bhava, carry that filthy bag 110 kilo, walk with a dog and die like a dog. Got the point? So no one can say that there is no God, because it amounts to say that I am not there. Even to say I am not there, I should be there. Therefore the statement is most illogical and absurd statement. Therefore all his purvapakshas are simply smashed with one answer. We are talking about attaining the God who happened to be your own real nature. If you are not interested in attaining your own real nature, may the Lord bless you, dirghayushman bhava. Live long life with diabetes, BP, cancer, loneliness, and dogs and neighbors. Dirghayushman bhava. Because I cannot curse anyone, I can pray for you, that's all. Because I only manifest in the form of even Nastika. That's why Bhagavan doesn't say, you are Nastika, therefore I will not give you food. He doesn't say, you are Nastika, therefore I will reduce your space. He doesn't say, you are Nastika, therefore I will not give oxygen. He doesn't say. He is Samaha, Samadarshinaha. But suffering cannot be avoided. As long as you deny your spiritual nature, as long as you deny the struggle to gain the spiritual nature, your life doesn't have any meaning. You remove this one goal of spiritual life. What is there in our life, you tell? Eating, sleeping, quarreling, dying. Ahara nidra bhaya maitunam cha samanyam etat pashubir narana buddhirhi tesham adhiko visheshaha buddhya vihina pashubis samana. Animalistic life. To live animalistic life, one doesn't need to possess human body. Got the point? So nowhere materialistic people can be a threat to our spiritual life. Understand? So have conviction and surrender to the Lord and do all spiritual practices, not to gain him, not to attain him, not to see him in the vision, not to go to any separate state of mind, samadhi or something, but to gain self-knowledge or qualification for self-knowledge. And the entire spiritual life is nothing but a sculpture bringing out a beautiful Krishna who is in the form of a rock. In our parampara, beautifully they will explain this. You don't need to gain divinity. Just you discover the hidden divinity. Like a sculpture, just by seeing a rugged rock, what he says? Hey, beautiful Krishna. The person next to him doesn't have that vision of seeing beautiful Krishna in a rugged rock. How can you say that there is beautiful Krishna? Wait a moment. He says to that friend, wait a moment, and takes his chisel and just removes the chunks, unwanted chunks. Correct? He removes the unwanted chunks from that rugged rock and he polishes that rock and finally he brings out the beautiful Krishna. Understood? Same thing is our spiritual life. We don't need to gain the divinity. Each soul is potentially divine. The work before is manifestation of the divinity. You do the work called bringing out your divinity, either by karma yoga or raja yoga, whatever name you give, that is up to you. That is the real spiritual life. Books and temples and dogmas are secondary details. I am just paraphrasing of Swamiji's quotation. Got the point? So, it is with us, we should have that vision. That vision is given in the Shastra, Amrutasya Putraha Tvamasi. With the belief, you just start your chiseling. Remove the chunks which are in the form of raga dvesha, unwanted chunks in our mind. Remove that by karma yoga. Then having removed, you just polish that particular form. That is polishing is in the form of meditation, upasana. Then finally, you put a beautiful eyes and nose. And you make the rugged rock as a beautiful, worshipful Krishna, who has done to himself this making divinity, who has manifested this divinity, which is already with him, is called a jnani. So we all will pray to the Lord and surrender to the Lord. Oh Lord, if possible, in this very Janma itself, I should bring out my own little Krishna, who is always in the form of myself. With this prayer, we conclude this series of talk. Is moksha attainable? What is the answer? It need not be attained. It cannot be attained. It should be discovered by removing all the unwanted portions, rugged, rough portions of our personality. That is the answer. We will conclude this topic. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Tat Sat. Sri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.